you got out of school, that's what you did. You went home and turned on the TV and watched Connecticut Bandstand. It was just the most terrific experience. You know, when you see this on TV, it's one thing, but then to go there and actually be in the studio, and of course on TV everything looks bigger than it is in person, so it was considerably smaller when you got there, but there was an electricity, a magnetism. It was really very exciting. They had a live group singing that day. Well, actually they didn't sing in those days. They played the records and they moved their lips, and they called it lip syncing, and they went and signed autographs afterwards, and it was really a very exciting experience. There was a group of kids who turned out to be what were known as regulars, and they turned out to be personalities. They would do dances and record hops with Jim Gallant. They would go to Long Island, around the Connecticut area. They'd sign autographs, they'd dance, and they themselves became personalities. Jim Gallant, of course, was a star of Connecticut Bandstand. The payola scandals broke in New York, and they were really after Alan Freed at that point, payola being disc jockeys taking money for playing certain records. There was an article in the paper, I guess the payola scandal broke on a weekday, and the next day Jim Gallant was gone.
Records, turntables, cameras, and all. Complete with the requests, which now include drawings sent in by listeners. I have a lot of fun televising or simulcasting the Dial Dunlap shows.
Also in 1961, popular Johnny Palmer became a magic personality with Hartford County's teenagers. Johnny, who has been with Channel 30 for 6 years, became master of ceremonies of Dance Time, a program designed especially for teenagers. And during the summer months, Dance Time was moved to the ballroom of Lake Compounds. Each week, hundreds of youngsters enjoyed dancing to records and meeting famous recording stars. In 1962, Johnny won the title of the most popular TV personality in the country in a contest conducted by TV Movie Screen Magazine.
Actually, it was the Brad Davis Show. It was the correct title, but nobody ever called it that. It was called The Milk Show because it was sponsored by the 2,300 dairy farmer members of Connecticut Milk for Health. It was a dance show. It was like a Dick Clark show. Kids would come in and they'd dance. I'd have guest stars. I had them all, Bobby Vinton, the Four Seasons.
The New York Rock and Roll Ensemble, and I predict this will be one of the big groups in America in 1969. I heard this record for the first time 2 days ago. I think it's going to be a big one for Leslie Gore. I Can't Make It Without You.
What is there to hope and dream for? If I cannot hope you care.